we have here? We have a Volvo XC90, completely stock. There isn't even power wire to run an amplifier in this car, so I'm using a PA amp. One channel of that amp, I believe, is 1,200 watts at 4-ohm. So, fuck all power, really. And that's 2.8s in the same box I have in my sedan. It's not optimized for this car, but I figured we'll throw it in for the hell of it and see what it does. Now, I have that signal coming way down here into my base knob, which goes through this DSP, which then runs over here to the transmitter to give me some mids and highs and playing music. This is just for driveway testing, but after seeing these results, I might go ahead and put a system in here with some 6.5s, because this cabin isn't bad for it, which is the shocking thing. So let's get a glimpse of that action right here. I mean, come on, that is just sick. Just to elaborate, we got a long extension cord going all the way over to the house, which is very, very far in the distance there. So I can't pull much power even if I wanted to. I don't even have a big amp, but check it out one window down now. Not bad at all. Let's check the flex. I think it's worse with one door open. So check the flex a bit. Yeah, that's what a stock car gets you, but it's a Volvo, so everything else is pretty tame. I'd like to say you can't get windy in a larger cabin, especially a stock one, much like this, to the point where I'm using a home audio PA amp doing maybe 1,000 watts, and a FM transmitter going for my mids and highs. So let's see what these 2.8s can do with maybe 1,000 watts on them. Completely stock Volvo XC90. Definitely have to do a little game of guess what the subwoofer is where I put the seats up, because this is ridiculous. Completely stock Volvo XC90, you know, everyone's blaming the cabin now because, you know, they want to give credit to someone being half decent at making a box. So stock to the point where I'm using my DSP through a bass knob into that PA amp that's on one channel, because it's old and only does high ohms, so I have to be forced to use one channel. It sucks. Anyway, and then this is my mids and highs FM transmitter, so let's check it out. Like, come on, man, that is sick. Oh, man. I've had my fun with lows, and on video, lows just come through better because they tend to do hair tricks and move a bunch of wind. And that's all fun, but apparently this box cannot play high, which is a ridiculous claim, considering I have meter scores to back that up. Yep. Anyway, here is some 28, and we'll go all the way up to 45, maybe even 50, and there isn't much to show, especially considering this is a Volvo, and, well, it's built better than most cars. That's at least, like, I haven't metered this yet. That's got to be at least like a 40 something. Let's go to 40 hertz. Let's see what we get for flex. Mm-hmm. answer is not much. God damn. Okay. It's loud. It's not like 50s or anything, but it's at least a 40. Let's go up to 50 hertz. Bluetooth cut out. That's unfortunate. Anyway, you get the point.
Success.